Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Well, here we'll take a look what is called bearer token. First, see what is bearer. Bearer means carrier and token means secret code. So bearer token means carrier of the secret code. Now, a token may look like this, pretty long, some random letters and things like that. So bearer token means carrier of the token. And who is the carrier? In general, your HTTP get request or HTTP post request. Now you send bearer token with the keyword bearer and the token together in a string format in the headers of HTTP get request and HTTP post request. So here, token in general is generated by the server first time when you sign up. If you have a new user and user wants to register, and for that registration using the password and username, for those two credentials in the backend server and REST API will generate token. And that token is called bearer token. Now that's saved in the server. So next time, if you have a route or a page that you want to show to the user only certain verification is done, or whether the user has registered or not, you use bearer token to do the authentication to know if there is a user like this. And if there is a user, you want to go to the user's page. Not just based on username and password, you also want to verify it using the token. So now here, this is the page where I want to go and see. I want to see my profile. So for this one, this profile page is protected using the token. So if there is a user for this page, so the server will try to find the user. And if it can find, it can also find a token for that user. So server will send me status code 200 with the bearer token together. So here I want to log in. So here I'll log in. So here I'm sending my phone number and password. And against this phone number and password in my server, I should have a token, unique token for this phone number and password. So once I call this sign in method, so it would talk to the server. And if the authentication is done, it will send me the token, okay? And this tells me that there is a valid user in the server or in my database, and that user can access this profile page. And as I just logged in, that token has been sent to me. Well, now, of course, sending the token from the server is not the job of the app. This is the job of the server side. But anyway, so since that token has been sent to me, I can save it somewhere in my app. And then next time I want to make some request or some pages that should be protected using this token I can use to do the conditional check whether a certain user has access to certain pages or not. Of course, this connects both front end and back end. And anyway, so if you have to send a token, you'd send it through headers just like this. Thank you.